Well, this video, what is this video going to be about? First of all, welcome back. I kind of jerry-rigged my cameras. If you remember my last video, if you saw it, it was just basically a screen capture. This one, I was able to find my cameras. As I explained in the last video, I'm in the middle of hopefully selling my house, and I packed a lot of stuff, so I found a camera or two. And first of all, it's very early in the morning. Kids went to school. The house is empty besides my dog, so hopefully he doesn't come walking in. But what I want to do today, and I'm recording this part first, so if I can get to it today, I might. If not, you'll probably see me with a different shirt on in the next, the next scene. What I want to do today is based off of my last video, which was my all for one preset for the Line 6 Helix. Again, I started tweaking and tweaking, and I just like messing around. I went to a blank preset, and what happened was I went through some of the templates, and I found the dual amp template on the Helix. So I started messing around with that, and wouldn't you know it, I came up with a tone or a preset that I might like a little better than the All for One preset that I just actually uploaded to Custom Tone on my website in the last week that I used at my last gig, which went very well. I wanted to use my in-ears, didn't use my in-ears. I ended up going with the wedge in front of me, which was kind of, iffy as far as the tone goes, but I got some good compliments out front from the sound guy, and actually the drummer from the opening band came up to me afterwards and said the tone was just like crystal clear and cut through the mix really well. It was good. So I was happy with that. So, but now I have this new preset, and at this moment, I believe it's called Dual Amps 1 or something like that. And I might change the name because it's not really dual amps. You're not using both amps at the same time. It's more of either or. And the way I have it set up, which you'll see, and what I'm going to do too is I'm not going to record this when I'm playing. I'm not recording it direct because I also have it running through. I just got a Line 6 Firehawk 1500, and I'm not using any of the amp tones on that. This is just to monitor my Helix on stage, more for my band to hear or to have some volume on stage as far as the guitar goes, so it's not an empty space, on that my side of the stage. But so you're going to hear pretty much this mic here and also possibly one of my camera mics. As far as guitar tone goes, it's not going to be direct like the last video I did or some of my other videos. So just keep that in mind that it's going to be more of what I'm hearing in the room. And it may sound, really bad to you listening on YouTube, especially with all the compression that YouTube puts on all the videos. You might get an idea of what it's going to sound like. But what I did was I'm not using snapshots in. I'm thinking about doing it because the way I have this set up is that it's almost like I have five, maybe six different amp tones, even though there's only two amps I'm using. I'm using a Fender amp, and I'm using the Marshall, I believe it's the 2204 mod. I'm going to say I did it a few days ago, so I don't remember exactly which model Fender that I used, but I'm going to, you'll see it, and I'll shout it out when I'm ready to play. So I have a setup where I can A/B both of those. I also set it up where there's two impulse responses, one for the Fender, one for the Marshall. But come to find out, I didn't even realize that I was using almost the exact same impulse response for both tones. So by the time I go to record the guitar part for this video, I'm probably going to take out one of the impulse responses. One of them slightly different. I think it's an Ohnhammer. And it was like the both of them are using a 57 from Mike, and one of them had it was more of a mid-range type tone. So I'm gonna try to decide between both of those impulse responses because I can get them pretty close as far as when switching the amps. So you're A/B-ing between a Fender and a Marshall, and the Fender is got a little bit of breakup on it. The Marshall is pretty good crunch, maybe a little more than AC/DC style. Sorry, that was my phone. And I have a tube screamer setup that you can get on either of them. I have the compulsive drive, which is, I believe, the OCD model that you can get on. You can put it on for either of them. I also set up controllers for both amps. So you have one foot switch that gives the Fender more amp gain, and you're not using, you don't have to use the overdrive pedals, but you can also add the overdrive on top of that to give you even more grit. So the Fender and the 2204 Marshall both have separate switches to add more natural amp gain. There are some effects. As I've said many times, I play in a Bon Jovi tribute, so I have like a Pog octave effect set up for You Give Love a Bad Name and Never Say Goodbye. I have a reverb that stays on all the time. I'm not one of those guys that likes to turn reverb on and off, so I don't use a switch for that. I got a, I believe there's a chorus, there's a phase 90, there's a flanger, kind of like Van Halen settings. And I have some delays set up. One of them is a long delay, which is dedicated to a foot switch. And the other one is, actually there's two more. So one of them just stays on all the time for rhythm. It's just a slight little delay, you'll hear it. The other one is the long delay, which you can use whenever. It's dedicated to a foot switch. And then the third one, I have a foot switch set up for a lead boost, which is going to, it's basically a gain block, 3.5 dB up. So when you hit that lead switch, it's also going to shut off the rhythm delay and turn on the third delay, which is in between the long delay and the rhythm delay. So it's more for leads. Like, it's not overpowering, but it adds a little bit more to your leads. So you got a wah pedal in there and the volume pedal set. So I think that's it. I talked enough here. So the next thing you're going to see, hopefully, I might have the same shirt on. Go Pats. They won yesterday. And if I don't get to it today, I'll have a different shirt on. Could be another Patriots shirt. Might not be. But let's see how this goes. And like I said, it's going to be going through a Firehawk 1500, which I will give my thoughts on that too coming up. So sit tight. Okay, I am back, and it is actually still the same day. I'm wearing the same shirt. You just can't see me because this was the easiest way for me to set this up. I got my camera pointing down. I'm using the same microphone you just saw previously. It's the Blue Yeti USB microphone. So I'm going to try to pick up through that microphone not only my voice that you're hearing now, but everything that's going on in this room. You're going to hear me clicking the foot switches. You're going to hear, probably going to hear the strings on the guitar. And by the way, I'm using my EVH, here it is, my EVH Music Man, Ernie Ball Music Man. Got it in 1991. I beat it to hell. It's the only guitar I used for like 20 years and wore the heck out of the thing. And just recently had it refretted, and they did a ton of work on it. And it's playable, but it's one of those guitars where I will probably not gig with it. I'll just leave it in the house. So I have the Firehawk 1500 here. So everything you're hearing is going to be coming out of this. I'm just using it as a monitor, and it's going to be going into the mic I have set up here in the room. And you see my Helix on my pedal board here. So this, I had mentioned I called it dual amps. I actually changed it to two amps rig. Just because, again, I'm not using, there are two amps models that I'm using in here, but they're not being used at the same time. It's more of an A-B thing. And I'll put up a photo too, just so you can see what I have assigned here. Again, I'm not using snapshots. I'm probably going to end up getting to that, but for the sake of this video, it's just going to be set up. It's laid out like a traditional pedal board where I have my overdrives and phaser and all that stuff, and just one switch and you're good. And that creaking you might be hearing is the chair I'm sitting in. It's an old chair, so sorry about that. Now, what I want to do first, I'm going to just say something about the Firehawk. I got it, and I'm not using any of the modeling or reverb or effects on it at all. I just got it just to amplify my Helix, because obviously the Helix has more updated tones in it. It's newer. I guess as a grab-and-go rig, the Firehawk would be fine. It's just, you want to go jam with your buddies, and you can actually probably use it for small gigs and stuff like that, but I just found that the Helix obviously sounds better, and you can do a lot more. So I'm really just going XLR left and right out, XLR in on this, the monitor in. And then when I play a gig, what I did last week was just go the XLR outs out of the Firehawk to front of house. And it worked out fine. You're able to, if you set it right, you're able to turn up the volume on the amp itself, on this itself, on stage, and it won't affect front of house. So you can, there's a dial on it. I'm not going to show you because it'd be too much moving, but there is a volume knob on the back of this, right where you plug into the monitor ends on here, that sets your level for the what you're sending the front of house. All right, so now to go off of what I said earlier, this is, there's two amps in here. I am using the Fender, which I think is the US Deluxe Normal, and also the Marshall Line 6 version of the 2204 mod, which is like a hot rodded JCM 800 type amplifier. And I did mention I was using two impulse responses, one for each amp. But before I started doing this part of the video, I took out one of them because they were both basically the same thing. They're an Onehammer 412 Marshall Creamback V30 with a 57 on it. And I'm using number 6, I believe, in that whole package that you get from Onehammer. It's on number 6. I'm not using any low cut and high cuts on that because I have an EQ block, a low cut and high cut block, right after the cabinet or the impulse where I, let me see if I can over to it. Yeah. My low cut's at 93. The high cut's around 9.9. You can adjust the taste. Sometimes I go higher or lower on both of those. But for right now, I like it where it's sitting. So let's hear the Fender. Now, each of these, right here, this very first button here, and I'm going to show you the photo. Like I said, I'll probably put it up a couple of times. I just call this AB, and that's basically just going back and forth between the two amps. When it's not lit up, it's the Fender. When it is lit up, it's the Marshall. Now, we're going to stick to the Fender for now. So I'm on the Fender. I have a reverb. I believe it's a plate reverb, simple reverb. There's a slight delay, and that's about it. Now, this switch here is actually what I labeled it Fender gain. So that's going to make the gain go from around 5 to 7 on the Fender amp, just to give a little more breakup and grit to it. It's not a totally clean sound, as you can hear. And you can hear the reverb, and you can hear the delay most likely. It's got a nice, you know, that classic Fender spank to it. Really be good for you country guys out there. It's got a nice little twang to it, but that's going to be used for my, you know, anything I need cleanish. If I need to go any cleaner, then I'm just turning my volume knob down on the guitar. So that's that. Now, if I need more grit to that Fender amp, like I said, I step on this up here, and that's going to give me a little more gain from the amp model itself. I'll go back and forth, not on the AB switch, but on the gain itself. I'll just hit the, you know, customary G. So you can, you know, I'm hoping you can hear, I guess when I watch back, when I edit this, I'll be able to hear it, but you should be able to hear the gain being added to it. That's that. Now, along with that, I'm going to shut the gain off on the Fender amp. I also have a Tube Screamer set up here, and I have the Compulsive, which is an OCD, set up here. Now, you can, they're stacked, so you can actually have both of these on with the Fender gain and go crazy if you want, or you can just get different flavors. The Tube Screamer is going to give you more of a it's going to sound more like trebly. Hopefully it goes through the microphone that way. I'll hit that, shut it off, then I'll go to the OCD, which is meant for more towards your metal sound. So here's that deluxe normal amplifier just by itself. And that's without the actual amp gain on. Now I'll turn on the Tube Screamer. Thank you. you can definitely hear it. It's got a good, nice crunch to it. If you're just a Fender guy and you stick on that all night, you can get through a whole gig just using that. So now I'm going to do the Fender gain on the amp itself, which puts it up to 7, and the Tube Screamer. Amp off. On. And also gives it a little bit of a volume boost, so it's perfect for leads. All right, so now the Fender gain on the amp is off, the amp model. I'm going to do the OCD, the compulsive drive, with the gain off on the amp. So as you can hear, or maybe you can't hear, but it's in the room, it's not as bright as the Tube Screamer, and it's got a little more, I don't want to say distortion, but maybe that's the right word, a little more distortion to it. So now I'm going to have the compulsive drive on and put the Fender amp gain on. The overdrive off with the amp gain only. With it on. Now, if you want to get crazy, all three are on. You got the Fender amp gain, you got the Tube Screamer, and you got the compulsive. Like I said, I don't know when I'd ever use that, but it's there. And when I do the snapshots, maybe I'll make a snapshot with crazy Fender distortion gain. Or anything like that. So I'm going to shut those drives off. I'm going to shut the Fender gain off. And I'll just let you hear the effects that are available for both of these amps, actually. So I got my volume knob turned down a little bit for the Fender. I have a Phase 90. Basic Phase 90 in simple Van Halen setting that I use it on a couple of songs here and there, but it's there. If I do, I'm probably going to upload this, so if you need to switch out effects, whatever, if you like the way the amp sound but you don't like the effects, take them out. I have your basic Van Halen style flanger. Some distortion. You get the idea. Now, the POG, this right here is the POG setting, which is just a basic simple pitch. I call it POG because I'm just trying to mimic the octave effect in that certain pedal, that certain effect. I'll get to that when I get to the Marshall amp. I also have down here next to the tap, I have a lead setting. As I mentioned earlier, it's a gain block. It goes up 3.5 decibels, so you don't have to rely on your sound guy to turn you up during your solos. And what that does is this delay, I'm hoping you can hear that. That delay will turn off. When I turn that on, the gain block will go active, and that delay that you just heard will become inactive, but it will also turn on my third delay, which is my lead delay, which is more pronounced. So I will turn this on and let you hear that delay. And I'll go back and forth, up and down, so you can hear, hopefully you can hear the volume difference. So it's off. Now on. I'll go back and forth, on and off, with just the chord. Off. On. Off. See, the delay's there, but it's not as prominent. On. On. And that lead is available with the Marshall too. The other effect is, like I mentioned earlier, a long delay, which you can probably figure out. It's very prominent, and the mix is at, I think it's around 50%, so I'll turn that on. And the first delay is pretty much gonna be as loud as the note that you're hitting. And then it starts dying out. What I like using that for, there's a couple of solos that I have to do that need that, but at a big ending in the song, let me get the gain on here, the OCD, and I'll shut the delay off. So when you hit the last chord, say it's an A chord, I'll usually be in tap tempo with the song. I'll hit that just for effect, and everybody gets happy. All right, so let's move on. That's that. Also, I have the, sorry for my naked leg, but it's warm in here. I have the volume pedal set up as a volume pedal, and I'm using the Crybaby Wah, which I'm not going to engage because I have a torn meniscus in this knee. I'm going to be having surgery, so I don't want to be putting any pressure on that I don't need to, because it doesn't really feel that good. All right, so basic. You guys know how to do that. Basic volume pedal. Nothing fancy, but it's good. If you need to go silent, it's there. All right, so let's get to the Marshall, which is the Line 6 2204 mod. That I actually really like this model, and I was using it previous to my All for One preset. For a lot of recordings I do, I use that model. I just love the 80s style, as you can tell from my videos. So, all right. So again, this first switch here is your amp toggle. Basically, you're going from Fender to Marshall. So I'm going to turn it on. So now we're at the. Sorry for the clicking. That's my. There's another reason I don't take this guitar out to gigs is I got something loose in the jack, so I need to get that checked out. All right, so we're on the Marshall, and the gain is set. Well, let's hear it. The gain is set pretty much, more. I guess it's more than an AC/DC type crunch tone. I love gain, so there's more than that. If you need to back it off, you just back it off. But that's the bass tone. It's got the same reverb, the same rhythm delay that I have on the Fender. Everything's the same except the amp is now changed. It's also going through that Onehammer V30 Creamback impulse. I wonder if my guitar sounds like it's going out a little bit. It's very humid in here for some reason. We're getting supposed to be getting a really bad rainstorm tomorrow, so. All right, so now, same thing. The second button up here is, right next to the Fender gain, is the Marshall gain. And all that does is add more gain from the amp itself with no overdrive pedals. I'll shut it off. So I'm hoping you can hear that, because I hear a huge difference in the room here. I really hope this mic is picking up the Firehawk. The Firehawk is really cool to get back on that, because there is, you probably know, if you haven't heard of it, it's got six actual speakers in it. It looks like a 12-inch in the middle. It's got, seems like two subs, and I haven't really researched this. I can kind of see through the grill. So it's got two subs in the lower right and left-hand corners. It looks like two horns in the upper right corners, and then above the 12-inch in the middle, it looks like it might have a tweeter, or maybe the tweeters are on the sides and the horns in the middle. Either way, you can actually, there's a setting on the Firehawk where you can set it to stereo and stereo wide. I have it set to stereo wide, and you can pretty much hear, even though there's one cabinet here, you can hear the sound spreading a little bit, which is really cool. instead of having two separate, cabinets next to each other or spread apart. If you're on a budget and you want that stereo spread, you can replicate it pretty well with that. All right, back to the amp model. All right, so we're on the Marshall. You just heard the Marshall gain from the amp. Now let's turn the Tube Screamer on. Now these are the same settings from the Fender. So here's it without the Tube Screamer. Tube Screamer on. Off. Yeah, that's probably where I would live most of my gigs playing rhythm is with that Tube Screamer on and nothing else. But when you need to get crazy, keep the Tube Screamer on, add the Marshall gain. It's just, and it's not over the top yet. Now, if I were to, let me shut the Marshall gain off and the Tube Screamer gain on. This is a long video. I've been asked recently by more than a few people to make longer videos. So I have time. So I'm just really going into each and everything. So hopefully you're sticking with me. If not, you can just use that dial and fast forward. All right, so now we're back to just the Marshall. And I'll add the OCD, the compulsive. Off. On. It's similar to the Tube Screamer on the Marshall. I can hear a bigger difference when I'm using the Fender, but on the Marshall it's similar. But it gives a little more distortion to it, and it's not as bright as the Tube Screamer. So now let's go to the Marshall gain on by itself and add the OCD. And you got sustain and harmonics for days using that. How about we do the Tube Screamer and the OCD together? That's probably a little bit too much for me, but hey, there's guys that love gain more than I do, so that might work. I'm not even going to, well, maybe I will. I'll add the Marshall gain in with that. That's just a little bit too much for me, but like I said, it might work for somebody else. And the effects are all the same. You got the lead. With that extra delay in there, you got the long delay. I don't need to play that. I'll try the POG setting, which is a simple pitch effect, and it's just set for an octave up. And I use that for, You Give Love a Bad Name. I'll just do the very beginning of that. So it's on now, so you got it. It's basically all it does, but it does it well, and I'm happy using it. So it's there. Like I said, if you don't like it, take it out. Let's put the Phase 90 back in. And you got Van Halen all day. Same thing with the flanger. I could just I'm so happy with the tone that I'm getting. I really wish there was a better way to get the sound I'm hearing in the room through the microphone and out to you guys without YouTube compression. I guess the best way is if you're in my area, come to a show. Haha. So that's it. I'm still working out the kinks on this a little bit, but I wanted to show you, what I've been working on. I got some good reaction off the last video, and I got good feedback off that Awful One preset at my last gig. I'm really thinking I'm gonna go with this preset, but in order to do that, because I use my Variax also for a few songs in the set, like a song like Have a Nice Day, it's a different tuning. So I have to make a separate preset based off of this with the Variax for a different tuning. And also during the solo, it changes tuning because Richie Sambora, when they used to play that live, when he was in the band, he used a double neck Tele and each one was tuned differently. And I also use it on their new one, This House Is Not For Sale, which is a different tuning. And from time to time, when we do Wanted, I'll use the Variax with the acoustic and the Variax for the intro, the 12 string. So I have to make a separate preset. So depending on how far I get this week, I might use this at my, I have a private corporate gig this weekend. So hopefully that this will work out well. I'm really, really, really digging the sound of these two amps, and the possibilities are endless, really. So that's all I have. I'm going to, let me see if I can pick up this. Here I am. Now, as you can see, I got the same shirt on. Here's the guitar, by the way. And I now have a Patriots hat on, so you can tell I'm a Patriots fan. Don't hate me. I'm just a New England fan all around. Celtics, Bruins, you don't care about that, but I figured I'd mention it anyway. So that is going to be it for today. I think I got through everything. I really hope I can sell my house and get into the new house and get my, I'll have a bigger room because this room here is, hey, there's this keyboard over there. This room here is really small. You can see all my amps and stuff. It's just, I'm trying to keep this kind of clean in here for when people come look at the house. So I'm rambling as I usually do because I'm Italian. And there it is again, Firehawk. And I'm actually using the Line 6 G70 wireless, which works out really well for me for my gigs. Sorry for all the shaking here. I don't have much lead to go on this. But anyway, and I need to shave. Anyway, until next time, as I always say, take care. We'll be right back.